In this next video, we'll talk about a serious disease of the cell cycle, known as cancer. The cell cycle and the rate of cell division is something that's controlled by the cell cycle control system. Normal plant and animal cells have a cell cycle control system. And what cancer is? Cancer is when normal plant or animal cells no longer listen to that cell cycle control system. Cancer is a disease of the cell cycle. Cancer cells do not respond normally to that cell cycle control system. Often, this cell cycle control system are telling cells to wait, to not divide, to not continue going through cell division. However, in cancer cells, the message to stop isn't listened to. Cancer cells can form tumors, which are abnormally growing masses of body cells. Tumors growing within a tissue can interfere with that tissue, but the biggest danger of cancer comes when those cancer cells and those tumor cells start spreading into neighboring tissues and neighboring parts of the body. We say that a tumor is malignant. If it has cancer cells that can spread to other parts of the body. Cancer cells are named based on the tissue in which they start, even if they end up traveling to other parts of the body. So in this case, there are cancer cells that originated in breast tissue. So this is a breast cancer. As that cancer starts spreading through the tissue which it was found in, it can interfere with the functioning of those tissues. But again, the biggest risk to the body and the survival of the individual is when those cancer cells start spreading through other tissues of the body, interfering with them as well. Now, one of the biggest requests which the medical community receives from the population in general is for a cure to cancer. We have some methods of treating cancer, and some of those treatments are showing incredible progress. However, cancer isn't one single type of disease, and what makes cancer difficult to treat is that the cancer cells themselves are human cells. They are the cells that are naturally a part of the body. It's simply human cells that are no longer following that cell cycle control system. So the main methods of treatment that we have for cancer include surgical removal, radiation therapy, and chemotherapy. And so let's talk about each of these. Surgical removal is actually the most effective form of cancer treatment. If the tumor can be entirely removed from the body and none of those cancer cells have spread to other locations, this is the method of treatment that has the greatest level of success and the least amount of negative impacts to other tissues of the body. However, surgical removal is limited to cancers which are found early enough that they haven't started to spread, and also cancers in areas which surgery can access those tumors. If that's not the case, if either the cancer has been around too long and has started to spread, or the cancer is in a location which cannot be surgically operated on, radiation therapy and chemotherapy are the next steps. Radiation therapy is exposing those cancer cells to high-energy radiation with the goal of disrupting the DNA in those cancer cells and interfering with the cell division. Now, cells which are rapidly dividing are most sensitive to radiation. And so that's why cancer cells are specifically harmed or damaged by radiation. Unfortunately, there are also other types of cells in our body which are rapidly dividing, and they also can be negatively impacted by radiation therapy. Chemotherapy is a technique in which chemicals or pharmaceuticals are used to interfere with cell division. Again, most of the cells in our body are not actively dividing, and so those cells are less likely to be negatively impacted by chemotherapy Whereas the cancer cells are rapidly dividing, and so their cell division will definitely be interrupted. But as with radiation therapy, unfortunately, there are some other cells in our body that are rapidly dividing, and so there can be a variety of negative side effects or consequences of both radiation therapy and chemotherapy. Research on cancer cells is an active area of study, and it is something that the medical community is focusing on, finding treatments which will be successful for treating the variety of different types of cancers. In fact, there's an immortal human cell line known as HeLa cells that were obtained from a sample of a cervical tumor from a woman named Henrietta Lacks. Unfortunately, Henrietta died in 1954. However, her tumor cells are still alive today and are continuing to grow. This cell culture has allowed scientists to make a variety of different scientific discoveries and new medical treatments. Modern medicine is indebted to individuals like Henrietta, whose diseases and cells have allowed for the medical progress that we see today. When it comes to cancer cells, prevention is even more effective than treatment. While not every type of cancer can be avoided, there are certain lifestyle choices and activities which can increase your risk for developing cancer or can increase the likelihood of cancer being detected early enough to be treatable. So the variety of suggestions here are either to prevent the formation of cancer in the first place or to catch cancer when it's still at an early treatable stage. So first is not smoking. There are many substances within tobacco smoke and other types of smoke which can interfere with the cell division in your lungs and in your mouth and in your trachea. And so, by avoiding tobacco, by avoiding smoking, this will help reduce some of that exposure of those sensitive tissues to mutagens. The next thing that you should do is to exercise adequately. Now, you may usually think of exercising as being something that's important for your heart, and it is. However, by exercising, your body's filtration systems also work, and you're able to flush out toxins and other materials from your body. And so, having an active lifestyle and having active exercise does decrease cancer rates as well. Avoiding excessive exposure to the sun. A little bit of sun exposure is okay, but the sun has high-powered ultraviolet radiation, and this radiation can end up damaging your skin cells. In fact, this is the cause of a sunburn, when the DNA of your skin cells is so damaged that the cells actually perform cellular suicide or apoptosis. So the more we restrict exposure to the sun, the less damage those skin cells will receive. Next, eating a high-fiber, low-fat diet. This will decrease your risk of developing certain forms of colon cancers and also keep your heart healthy as well. The next two suggestions are things you should do to increase the likelihood of discovering cancer while it's still treatable. This includes visiting the doctor regularly and also performing regular self-examinations. As I had said, finding cancer in its early stages allows for a greater variety of treatment options, and those treatment options typically are far more successful than cancer, which is only discovered at later stages. Now that we've talked a bit about cancers, let's talk about a different type of cell division that has a very specific purpose. Let's talk about meiosis.